The circular scheme or plan brings each district closer to the central dome, which contains the medical, food, shopping, everything else that people need. The circular arrangement makes it easier to operate using far less energy than any other system. And if you start at one end of the city and go through the city, you always return to the same place. Whereas in a linear city, you go to one end, you have to backtrack to get to the same point. So the circular scheme is by far the most efficient. And when cities are contracted in the future, they will be contracted as a whole, as an entire system. In that way, all of the parts and components would be delivered in stages. Like sequel one will be the underground, the heating system, the electric generators, the piping systems, the recycling systems. Then after that, the next layer, which would serve as the first layer that contains the architecture, the foundations for all the buildings, and after that, the erection of structures up from the foundations. Starting with the central portion of the city, working its way out to the different radial sectors, and then out to the final housing sectors, and then to the agricultural belt, and then to the recreation areas. The cities themselves are prefabricated. Most of the elements that comprise the structures of the cities are interchangeable, interlocking. They are designed so they can be disassembled just as they were assembled. So the new cities will be updated continuously. As the waters are piped into the cities, they are checked. And to whatever extent contamination exists, the water processing plants evaporate the water, recondense it, and cleanse it. All of the rooftops are photovoltaic. All of the skin, outer skin of the building, converts solar radiation into electrical energy. As we move beyond the third sector, we come to tennis courts, parks. Beyond that is a residential district, which consists of lakes, waterfalls, all kinds of beautiful plants throughout the area. And each house is concealed by plants, so you can't see another building. Some people prefer, as in the next sector, to live in apartment houses. The apartments have drama groups, recreation, swimming pools, discussion groups, and so many other facilities. The disadvantage of living in a private home is you would have to go to the various places to access the same things. Instead of motor vehicles in the city, all transportation is carried on by circular conveyors that we call transveyors. They move radially, circumferentially, and vertically. They serve the function of elevators, buses, conveyors. But if you wish to go to another city, you can take an elevator down beneath the central dome, which has maglev trains, etc., that will transport you to the center of any other city or any other region. There will be no waste products. Just as in nature, there are no waste products. All materials that we would formerly call waste would be recycled and converted into new products. And that when the city hits a certain number of people, we stop the development and let everything go back to nature between this and the next city. It doesn't mean that we can solve all the problems. We can just design and build a far better environment to advance all human beings.
Now, this looks like some sort of submerged stadium with something.
We might build circular cities in the sea, where the water's about 30, 35 feet deep. Most of the apartment houses will open out into the sea. You can observe marine life and fish swimming by. There'll be no zoos, no seaquariums. Everything will be observed in natural conditions. There'll be boating, scuba diving, recreation, and universities built in the sea.
These drawings all made by you?
Yes. Thank you.
This represents a blueprint of the basic structure of the city and the sea. There are helicopter landing areas on the upper section. There are cranes that travel around the entire upper portion of the structure. The legs are designed to move up and down to support the structure and rest on the seabed. Now, what are these cities in the sea for? Some of them represent hospitals that can be towed off the coast of Africa or India. Instead of sending building materials out there and building a hospital, then shipping the equipment out there, it's much easier to build a floating hospital, tow it off the coast of Africa, use it, and by the time the new hospitals are assembled there, you can then move this to another region, float it to another region. Most of the cities will be constructed in dry docks by automated systems. After it's complete, the flood locks are open and it fills with water. And there are units that look like tugboats that deliver the cities to their site where they'll be located. Some will house as many as 1 million people, a series of cities in close proximity joined together by transport systems, that is, tunnels either under the water or above the water bridges. This is an aerial view of one of the many variations of cities in the sea. The towers are used for residential occupation. The docks surrounding the cities are used for marine exploration and redevelopment. In other words, to restore the reefs, the damaged reefs. The unit in the center is used for hydroponic gardens, growing of food without soil. Now, many of the cities in the sea will have docking facilities for marine vehicles. And that would be like an underwater bus that would take people around to visit the different areas. You'll be able to get a very good picture of the ocean and how we harness it and use it and preserve it and protect it so that future generations might enjoy the oceans also. This projects above one of the cities under the sea with an observation platform and a landing platform on the upper deck. At the sea level, there'll be a floating dock system that moves with the tide up and down so boats can dock. Then you enter an elevator shaft which goes through an airlock. It takes you to the bottom of the sea or the seabed. The seabed is used for observation of reefs and marine life. Not only do they monitor the reefs, they restore the reefs and change them, rebuild them, or redesign them. Someday we'll be able to control the shape, configuration of reefs so they can support more marine life. I think humans can add to nature and improve it considerably. What will that mean? It'll mean a higher standard of living for all people.